learnt about the relative velocity of an object which is traveling in two dimension. Then we learnt what is projectile motion, and after that we learnt the equation of a path of a projectile. So here this is the equation of a path of a projectile. So this equation is the equation of a parabola of second order symmetry about y-axis. So this is y-axis, hence path followed by projectile is parabola. So this path of the projectile is parabola. So this is known as, so if I write, this is equation of path of parabola. So now let us draw the diagram for the parabola again. So now what you had x-axis and y-axis for projectile motion. So this is y-axis and this is x-axis. So this is the origin. So your projectile started like this and ended like this. So this is the trajectory of the projectile. So now let us understand the components or the variation of the components of velocity of projection of the projectile during the flight of the projectile. So this here is what u, initial velocity u. So the components of u, so I've already discussed. So ux component is equals to u cos theta and uy is equals to u sin theta. So now if you come here, so at this point the projectile will have the components of uy, and this will be again ux, that is u cos theta. So at this point, at a maximum height, so you don't have the y component. What you will have is only the x component, which is equals to u cos theta, and y component ui or uy is equals to 0. So this is the maximum height that is reached by the projectile. Now at this point, again, you have negative velocity, or the projectile is moving in a downward direction. So x component will be again u cos theta. Now at this point, so at this point what you have is you have the ux is equals to u cos theta, and uy, which is equals to u sin theta, and the direction will be somewhat like this. So here this makes an angle theta. So this is again made an angle theta. So this is the variation of the components of the velocity u for the projectile. So at different points we are understanding what will be the x and y components for the projectile. So what you have to do, you have to resolve the u vector into two components. So that is ux is equals to u cos theta and uy is equals to u sin theta. So the horizontal component, if you observe, horizontal component has remained constant throughout the journey of the projectile, because there is no force that is acting on the projectile due to gravity in a horizontal direction. So hence this component of a projectile, or the x component of a projectile, remained same throughout the journey. So this, as I said, you can clearly observe from the diagram. Here it is u cos theta, u cos theta, u cos theta, u cos theta, and u cos theta. So the x component has remained सेम और कॉन्स्टेंट थ्रू आउट द जर्नी ऑफ द प्रोजेक्टाइल. Why? Because there is no gravity that is acting in a horizontal direction. Now, let us observe the y component. So, initially uy was equals to u sin theta. As you observe throughout the trajectory, then you can see there is a decreasing velocity of the projectile as it goes from point O to point, let's suppose this be B. So why? Because the projectile with the initial velocity u at a point A will be zero. So this velocity of a projectile at point A will become zero. So when this velocity becomes zero, so there will be no y component. So if this velocity is not equals to zero, then this projectile can move even higher distances and then fall back. But now at a point A, the projectile loses its velocity and the y component becomes zero. So here it is u sin theta, here uy, and here uy is equals to zero. And now if you observe, the uy is in negative direction. So this is because the earth attracts the projectile towards the center. So at every point the earth tries to attract this projectile towards the center of the earth. So how can it attract towards the center of the earth? But by the help of acceleration due to gravity, the earth attracts the projectile towards the center of the earth. So this happens at every point of the trajectory. So after attaining the highest point, so highest point is A. So after attaining the highest point, so if you observe, the projectile has the downward journey. So now the vertical component UY starts decreasing. So here UY decreases and becomes equals to u sin theta. So at that time it hits the ground. So this is because the earth is exerting the downward force on the projectile. So in this case, the velocity at the highest point is u cos theta. So this velocity is horizontal component of the velocity, so that is equals to u cos theta, whereas vertical component becomes zero at a highest point, at a point A. So at the end, what you conclude is projectile motion is a combined effect of horizontal motion with uniform velocity and the vertical motion with a uniform acceleration. So in horizontal direction you have uniform velocity, and in y axis or in a vertical motion you have uniform acceleration. So this is the variation of the components of velocity for a projectile projected with an angle theta. So this is the diagram. So next let us find what is the maximum height that is attained by a projectile. So what is the maximum height? So you saw in a diagram, so the maximum height was at a point A. So let us write the definition. The maximum vertical distance traveled by the projectile during its journey is called maximum height attained by the projectile. So this is the maximum height that is attained by the projectile. So the maximum vertical distance traveled by the projectile during its journey is called maximum height attained by the projectile. So the vertical upward motion will be in which direction? So that will be in y-axis or in vertical direction. So from the kinematic equations you can write Vy square minus V naught y square is equals to 2ay, and this again y. Since we are considering the vertical upward motion, so here I am writing the subscript as y. So Vy is the velocity of a projectile in a y axis. V naught y is the initial velocity of a projectile in a y axis, and this Ay is acceleration in y axis, and y is the displacement that is produced by the projectile in vertical upward motion. So we know V naught y is equals to u sine theta, and Ay is equals to minus g. And now this y, let us take this y as capital H. So this gives the maximum height. So substitute all this in an equation. For that, at a maximum height, velocity of a particle will be zero. So this you have to consider first. So velocity will be zero. So now what will be this equation becomes? Zero square minus u sine square theta, u square sine square theta is equals to minus 2gh. So from this equation, let us write for h. H will be equals to what? U square sine square theta divided by 2g. So this is the maximum height that is gained or attained by the projectile. So if you observe clearly, h is directly proportional to u square, and h is directly proportional to sine square theta, and h is inversely proportional to acceleration due to gravity. So here h is maximum height attained by a projectile, u is initial velocity, g is acceleration due to gravity. So to get this, we have substituted this data. So in y direction, v naught y will have the component u sine theta, ay will be equals to minus g, y is equals to h, and vy is equals to 0. So from this we wrote the maximum height, that is h, is equals to u square sine square theta divided by 2g. So this equation is again an important equation. Try to understand how I wrote this equation with the help of this equation. So I am telling this again, this equation is important equation. So there are basically 3 to 4 equations that you encounter in a projectile motion. So that equations are very, very important for the CET exam. So try to understand that equations, so such that you can solve the problems easily. So next is time of flight. So the next concept in a projectile motion is time of flight. So you found the maximum height that is attained by a projectile. Now let us understand what is time of flight of a projectile. So this is the total time taken by the projectile from the point of projection till it hits the horizontal plane. So this is what the time of flight means. It says the total time taken by the projectile from the point of projection till it hits the horizontal plane having point of projection is called time of flight. So the total time that is taken by the projectile to move from origin till it hits the ground. So that is the time of flight of a projectile. So to find that, so we need to have an equation, kinematic equation, y is equals to v naught x. So here again it is not x, it is y, multiplied by t plus half a y t square. So why? Because the projectile is moving in a vertical direction. So let this time small t be capital T. So this t is equals to time of flight. So what the capital T says? Capital T says the time of flight. So now y will be zero when it hits the ground. So or net displacement in y direction is zero when the projectile hits the ground. So y is equals to zero. And now you have v naught, y is equals to u sin theta, that you have already understood in the last section. And ay is equals to minus g, because acceleration due to gravity is acting opposite in direction to the direction of the projectile. Hence this is ay is equals to minus g. So this equation will give you the value of t. So substitute all this in a above equation. If you substitute, then what you will get is y is 0, v naught y is u sin theta, and this is multiplied with t. So here I am taking the capital T, and this is minus half g t square. So now what you want? You want the time of flight, that is capital T. So u sin theta t is equals to half g t square. So this t will get cancelled. What remains is t is equals to u sin theta. This goes up divided by g. So hence t is equals to 2u sin theta divided by g. So now you can say the time of flight is dependent on initial velocity u, and it is again directly dependent on the theta, and it is inversely proportional to the acceleration due to gravity. So what? T is directly proportional to u, t is directly proportional to sin theta, and t is inversely proportional to g here acceleration due to gravity. So this overall equation gives the time of flight of a projectile. So what we have done to understand the time of flight of a projectile, we have written an equation y is equals to v naught y t plus half a y t square. So from this, or from the projectile motion, we know t is equals to capital T, whereas capital T is the time of light, and V naught y is equals to u sine theta, and ay is equals to minus g. And after substituting all the data that we have in an equation, then we get t is equals to 2u sine theta divided by g. So this is the time of flight of a projectile. Now let us understand the horizontal range of a projectile. Horizontal range of a projectile. So this is the third section in a projectile motion. First we understood the maximum height, second is time of flight, and third is horizontal range. So this distance from here to here is known as horizontal range. So this can be said as the maximum horizontal distance traveled by a projectile is horizontal range. So from this point to this point, or this can also be said the maximum horizontal distance between the point of projection, so this is the point of projection, and to the horizontal plane where the projectile hits the ground. So this is horizontal range. So from here to here is the horizontal range. OB gives the horizontal range. So what is the definition now? The maximum horizontal distance traveled by the projectile is called horizontal range. So I have said, or I have shown from the diagram, so what is horizontal range? So if you don't understand the definition, so then you keep the diagram in your mind and directly write the definition. So for horizontal motion, so what you can write? X. So X gives the horizontal distance. X is equals to V naught xt plus half ax t square. So why we are taking x as a subscript? Because we are finding the horizontal distance, so we are not worrying about the vertical distance. So vertical distance we have already found, or the maximum height. So maximum height is in the vertical direction, so we found the vertical direction. Now it is time to find the horizontal motion. So x here is r. So r is what? Range of projectile. So x gives the range of projectile. So in last to last equation you saw y is equals to h. So where h gave you the maximum height, here you have r. R is range of projectile. Now we know v naught x is equals to u cos theta, and t is equals to capital T. So this is time of flight. And now ax is equals to 0. Why? Because there is no acceleration in a horizontal direction. So now if you substitute all this in above equation, r is equals to u cos theta, and this is multiplied by t plus half 0 t square. So what you get is r, so this term will be 0, is equals to u cos theta t. So but we know that t is equals to 2u sine theta by g. Substitute this in this equation, what will be r? R is equals to u cos theta, which is multiplied by 2u sine theta divided by g. So from this what you get? So you get 2u square cos theta sin theta divided by g. So R is equals to 2 u square divided by g sine theta cos theta. So this is R. So from trigonometric function we know that what is sine theta cos theta. So 2 sine theta cos theta can be written as sine 2 theta. So we need only sine theta cos theta. What will be the value? Sine theta cos theta will be sine 2 theta by 2. Substitute this here. What you get? R is equals to 2 u square by g multiplied by sine 2 theta by 2. So 2 will get cancelled. What remains is R is equals to u square by g sine 2 theta. So this is the value of R. So R is dependent on u square and sine 2 theta, and R is inversely proportional to g. So now what will be the maximum range of a projectile? So the range of projectile will be maximum if this sine 2 theta is maximum. So to find what is the maximum range of projectile, we need to have the range of projectile if sine 2 theta is maximum. That is, you should have it as 1. So 2 theta should be equals to 90 degree. So sine 2 theta should be equals to 1. You get this value as maximum. So what will be the theta value? So theta will be 45 degree. Because sine 90 is 1. So to make this as a sine 90, you have to have the theta is equals to 45 degrees. So 45 multiplied by 2 will give sine 90, and the sine 90 is 1. Substitute this in the above equation. So what you get? R is equals to u square g by sine 2 theta. So if 2 theta is equals to 1, then you get R is equals to u square by g. So this is the maximum range of a projectile. So thus, the projectile has maximum range if it has, or if it is projected at an angle 45 degree with the horizontal. So this is the R, or a maximum R. So to get maximum range of a projectile, what we have done is, so this equation, or in this equation we need to have the sine value as 1. We know that sine has a maximum value 1, and that theta is 90 degree. So sine 90 degree is 1. So if you have sine 90 degree here, then you will have the maximum range. So to do that, what we have done is we have taken sine 2 theta is equals to 1. So to get 1, what should be the value of theta? So that should be the half of 90 degree, that is 45 degree. We know that sine 90 is 1. So to get sine 90, we have to multiply 45 degree to 2. Then we'll have sine 90, that is equals to 1. So if you substitute that here, then you will get R is equals to u square by g sine 2 theta and R is u square by g. So the projectile has maximum range if it is projected at an angle 45 degree with the horizontal. So if you project the projectile at an angle 45 degree, then the range will be maximum. So R max is u square by g.